Hi viewers, welcome to Akshaya Vlogs and Crafts. Today, let's see Nyanamalai Sri Subramanya Swami Temple. Lord Muruga is the embodiment of Jnana, spiritual insight. He is Jnana Panditan, Jnana Swaruban. By worshipping the Lord as Jnana Panditan, one obtains Jnana. Until recently, the celebrated Nyanamalai Mount of Wisdom could not be identified. Lord Jnanamurugan only recently disclosed his presence at Jnanamalai, situated near Kaveri Pakkam in Velur district at a small village called Govindacherry, 14 kilometers from Kaveri Pakkam. Though it is a small hillock, yet there is no easy way to reach the top of the hill. There is a small Murugan temple on this hill. In the year 1998, some local people along with archaeological department officials discovered a worn stone inscription which translated affirms, in the 18th year of King Sambhuva Raya's rule, his son Prince Kaliga Rayan established steps to reach Jnanamalai of this village. The period is established as AD 1322 to 1340. On seeing this news item in the newspaper, Dinamani, our Tirupugal Tondar, Ra Krishnan, the author of several books including Arunagirinathar, Adichivatti, in the footsteps of Arunagirinathar, visited the site, conducted research and established conclusively that this Stalam is indeed Jnanamalai, celebrated in the songs of Saint Arunagirinathar. Hectic activity followed, and last year some Abhishegams were performed by our Siruvapuri Murugan Abhishega Committee, and on 15 September 2000 Kumbhabhishegam was performed after moderate renovation by the villagers. There is a small temple in typical Pallava style on the hill with a small sanctum and a mandapam. The Lord is in the form of Brahma Hasta, having rosary and kamandala in two hands. The other two hands are in Habeya Mudra and resting upon the hip. Generally in Tondai Mandalam, North Tamil Nadu, Pallava and early Chola images confirm to this Brahma Hasta form. About 3 feet high with Valli and Devasena as consorts, these are beautiful Moolasthana Vigrahas. He is called Balasubramanyar by local people. Near the temple, there is a small natural water source from which water is brought for temple usage. On to the west, there is a small Shiva temple, and behind we can see footsteps in the rock. They appear as footprints on molten lava. Incidentally, this is a volcanic mountain from all appearances. These footsteps are considered by the local folks as those of Lord Muruga himself. There is also a belief that Murugan visited this place after marrying Valli Amman in Vallimalai on the way to Thiruthani. Thiruthani and Vallimalai form a triangle with Jnanamalai, and both can be seen from this hill. Around the hill, there is a lake, and in rainy season, will look like an island. Arunagirinathar came to Jnanamalai and recalled his experience of being hated by his wife, own family members and local folks, decides to end his life, and at that time, Murugan shows his lotus feet and blesses him. He wants the same blessing again. This internal evidence of the saint's life is found only in the Tirupugal of Jnanamalai. This Tirupugal starts with Mani Aval Nagaika Uril Anaivarum Nagaika Loha. There is also another Tirupugal for Jnanamalai starting Sudu Kolai, help me make Jnanamalai accessible to Murugan devotees. In order to facilitate worship this important Murugan temple, we need to provide steps and other basic amenities. Siruvapuri Murugan Abhishega Committee members decided to construct the steps as well as other facilities. On August 19, 2001, in the presence of Mr. T.R. Srinivasan, IAS, Special Commissioner for Hindu-Religious Charitable Endowments of the Government of Tamil Nadu, a foundation stone was laid and the formal inauguration of this great task was undertaken with the blessings of Lord Nyanamalai Murugan. For about 5 hours, Thirupugal Anbargal sang Thirupugal followed by Abhishegam and Annadhanam. Hundreds of people attended this great event. The hill temple vibrates with the crowd that starts arriving for Adi Kartikai, which is the following day. Thousands come, most of them carrying kavadi, a phenomenon associated with Murugan. Nyanamalai looks fresh and clean, the ambience of typical of a place where Mandalabhishekam is on after consecration. But this hill is special. Muruga is the lord of Kurunji, the terrain of mountains, and he has countless hilltops as his abode. Nyanamalai and the small temple stand out for the fact that this is the place Arunagirinathar mentions in one of his Tirupugal verses, a place that had been exclusive for many years. The Tirupugal referred to is Manaiyaval Nagaika, in which Arunagirinathar mentions Nyanamalai. This hill in Velur district, however, remained as Idam Vilanga Thalam until 1998, when an inscription gave a clue, explains Valayapettai R. Krishnan, Tirupugal scholar and a Murugan researcher, the author of several books on the subject. He thinks the discovery of Nyanamalai, its development and consecration mark a milestone in his journey. On learning about an inscription on a rock of Nyanamalai, V. Muralidharan of Thiruvannamalai visited the spot. He came back with details which made Krishnan go there for investigation. Convinced that this was the hill Arunagirinathar mentioned in the hymn, he set about the task of making it known to the public. In the past 20 years, the members of Siruvapuri Abhishek Committee and Jnana Ashramam Trust, with the help and guidance of generous donors, have built steps to the hilltop and a motorable path besides facilitating water supply, etc. In this hill temple, Murugan is in an unusual form, with Vali on his left lap and the right arm around her waist. The deity is seated on his mount, the peacock, and hence the name Kuramagal Taluviya Kumaran. After marrying Valli at Vallimalai, Murugan passes Nyanamalai, where he chooses to spend quiet days with his newly wed wife. A honeymoon of sorts, remarks Krishnan, who explains the Tirupugal link. A huge depression on the rocky surface here is worshipped as the footprint of Subramanya. Ecstatic on seeing the footprint, Arunagiri in the hymn beseeches to his favorite god to show his feet, the same feet which saved his life in Thiruvannamalai. Adiyanu ninaithu naalum udaluyir vidutha podu anugi mun alitha padam arulvaye, goes the Tirupugal. The Lord responds by appearing with Valli on a peacock, proving right that Kandar Alangaram line Neela Sigandi Ileri Kola Kurathiyudan Varvan. At a metaphysical level, Valli is the embodiment of wisdom. The renovation committee has built a hall around the footprint for devotees to meditate. At the foothill is Jnana Siddhi Ganapati facing west. He holds in his four arms axe, mango, cane and a bunch of flowers. The greenery makes the 150-step climb a pleasant experience. Pointing to the image of Jnana Dakshinamurti beneath a tree, Krishnan says, the presence of this Kal Aala tree made us place the statue here. The biosphere has rare species of flowers and herbs. He informs Nelli is the Stala Vriksham. The outline of the twin hills of a faraway Cholingar is hazily visible in the noon glare. Incidentally, Nyanamalai, Vallimalai and Tirutani lie in a straight line. First stop after the ascent is Jnana Saraswati in a meditative posture. The original Jnana Pandita Swami temple is a few yards away. Close by stands a huge spear, Jnana Veil, a symbol of wisdom. The moreover is Brahma Shastra form, a common form in most of the temples of the south, built by Cholas and the Pallavas, informs Krishna. The deity in this Pallava structure is flanked by Valli and Devasena. South of this shrine is the temple of Kuramagal, Talaviya Kumaran. The hill temple has space for Jnana Veli Siddhar, Pale Siddhar, whose guru was Arunagirinadar Pitam. This is marked by a presence of Jnaneshwarar in the form of a lingam. Jnana Pungodai, Jnana Ganapati, Jnana Subramanyar, and a beautiful sculpture of Vishnu Durga complete the constellation. Padithiruvila, Adi Krithigai, and Kandasashti are celebrated with great fanfare. The entire project, including the steps, yoga, Anubhuti Mandapam, on the landing, the guest house at the foothill, which includes accommodation for the Achaka family and amenities for devotees, have all been created over a period of time with generous donations. Funds are needed to maintain the temple and the infrastructure and to conduct festivals and pujas. The hill, which is special in many ways, should be developed and more devotees should visit the place where Arunagirinadar had a second glimpse of his feet, says Krishnan, whose lifelong mission is to spread the glory of Tirupugal and bring to light more places underlined by Saint Arunagirinadar. Let us all have a good, pleasant darshan of this Lord and get his blessings. Thank you, viewers. Bye-bye, viewers.